Class 4 over the 1,200 metres for race number 3 on New Year's Day's 11-race programme. Headed by Hard Promise, who's run up a Happy Valley over this trip. Last time out behind a split of a second. Regency Darling gets the blinkers back on. Already a winner this season. King Mortar, a course and distance winner 2 seasons ago. Mr. Darth Vega makes his debut, as does Triumphant Lord. Young Empire, Barrier 5, will roll forward from there. And HK Tourbillon gets the blinkers on for the first time from Barrier 10 with Matthew Poon in the saddle. Horses that have been on the road, Young Empire and Bingo, both of them returning back on the 29th.
Well, it looks like there should be some good pace in this race with the likes of Young Empire, who likes to lead. Recently, he's been doing that, and he has either been in the outright lead or up sharing the pace. Bingo will go forward from gate number 2. Victor Wong certainly likely to do that. You'd see Regency Darling getting a nice run in the trail. Burstaway is in danger of being caught wide from his stall, and so too is Mr. Darth Vega, who's been trialling well. He could be settling back towards the end, but wide.
Hard Promise, the first one we'll have a look at here with him. He's going nice. He ran a good race last time, probably one of his best since he's been here. Nice second, behind split of a second, and he's under a decent hold as he comes down. This looks like his grade, Class 4. He's run well in Class 4, and he comes back here to Chartin. Burstaway, it looks a little bit tough from him from the draw, Barrier 12. Blinkers will come off him, though, on race day, but he moves nice enough here. He's nice and relaxed, just galloping under his own steam as he finishes off his little piece. And here's the first start. I thought I'd show him as well. Mr. Darth Vega, just working with Starlight, who's on the inside there, and Mr. Darth Vega doing nice, easy work here. He looks pretty forward for a good run. He's 1165 pounds. He's had 5 trials. The force is strong with this one.
Let's hope so. Two debutantes. Have a look at them both in a minute. We're going to the trial files, actually, for our form pointers, starting off with Hard Promise.
Beto Jung, Sylvester De Souza teaming up. This was his second going back to the 20th of December. He was on pace in this trial. I thought he sweated up quite a bit on this occasion as well, but I thought he did trial nicely. He was just run over late last time out in the race. That was won by a split of a second. I thought this was nothing wrong with his trial. You can see Big Party pulling down there on the rail to the line. So I thought a nice enough trial from him. He's yet to win from 15 starts, but I think a win on recent form, and that trial is not far away.
Yeah, I've got him in the numbers. He's only having his 4th start for the new stable as well, so he's going well.
All right, and this is Mr. Darth Vega at the trials. Just a quiet one at Chartin.
Yeah, he's the one with the yellow cap there. Just you can see him about 5 off the rail, and it was a very quiet trial from him. He wasn't pushed out at all. But you can see after the line, it's interesting, this trial, is that they let him keep running, and he's actually in front about, just about if he keeps running. You can see he's about in front about now. But you can see how, you can see the point I was making. They let him run afterwards.
A horse in that trial as well, Win-Win, finished second in that trial, ran well on the weekend. This is the other debutant, Triumphant Lord.
Yeah, he was hard-ridden, I thought, in this recent trial. He was up on the pace. He won a trial at Titeco in New Zealand by 3.5 lengths, and he was 3rd in a trial at Cambridge as well. The Dam, she won a few races with John Sargent, but I thought it was just a fair trial from him on that occasion.
Yeah, tongue tie goes on. I didn't mind his trial in New Zealand. I had a look at that Titeco one. It was quite impressive. So I'm going to take a chance on him and put him in on a minor line.
All right, this is Young Empire back at the start of December. Haven't seen him since October when he pulled up with a heart irregularity.
Yeah, he had the odd excuse last time out. He's yet, he's had 3 wins from 30. This trial was okay. I don't know how much we can probably take out of this. You can see a couple of the others there really put under a bit of pressure. Young Empire, Dylan Moe riding. Trial was okay. He did have excuses, but he was at a big price last time.
Yeah, I'm happy to watch him go around. Actually, he's had a few issues.
All right, okay. That's Young Empire, 18 and 10 a place about him at the moment. Our favourite, Paul, is the debutant, Mr. Darth Vega.
Yeah, I've got him on top too. I've seen enough to suggest he's going to run well. And it's interesting, Zach Purden's ridden him in all 5 trials, so he's stuck with the ship all the way through. A Hard Promise, it was a good run from him last time, and he's improved, I think, since he's gone to the new stable. Gracious Rider, now he pops up occasionally. He's had the 2 wins, one at Chartin and one at Happy Valley. But from Barrier 3, he'll get a nice run. I don't think this is the strongest race around, so I'm going to give Triumphant Lord a bit of a chance too. Just on the back of that New Zealand trial, was pretty impressive. He's definitely got ability, and maybe he's just one of these horses that doesn't like the all-weather. So 6, 1, 9 and 8, but I think 6 can win this race.
My selection in the race as well is Mr. Darth Vega. Look, he is drawn wide, but he has shown a little bit of speed in his trials, so it'd be interesting to see what they decide to do with him from the get-go, Mr. Darth Vega, number 6, but he's on top. I've got 2 Regency Darling in wide, no cover last start, and the prior start as well, and has won off a higher mark in the past, Regency Darling. Hard Promise goes in. And I threw in Gracious Rider, David Hall and Chad Schofield from a kinder gate this time out. He drew wide in the race on the all-weather behind Happy Tour. 6, 2, 1 and 9.
All right, same cue as you again, Paul, but other way around. 1 and 6 for me. Hard promise. User experience. How many Star Wars jokes have you got up your sleeve, just so I know for tomorrow, if you're casing wins?
I've got a few.
Right, OK, yeah. Good enough. That's race number 3.